Can you hear my voice?
There's someone who cannot hear our voice.
Okay, I can hear you and I can see the screen.
Okay.
Okay, you can start off.
Now let's begin. Hi everyone. Welcome to the TechV community meeting for May. I'm Jay Lee, a maintainer of the TechV project and one of the WAF SIG leaders. And I'm working in PingCap. It's my pleasure to be the moderator for the TechV community meeting. Before the meeting begins, I would like to remind all of you to mute your microphones when others are talking. Also, please be aware that this meeting is recorded and the video will be uploaded to YouTube after the meeting. And the first, I would like to invite all of you to give a brief introduction to yourself, about yourself. And some of our team members are in Beijing office. So let's begin with one team.
Hi everyone, can you hear me?
Can you hear me?
I believe they can.
Okay. Hi, this is Wenting from.
Okay. Wen Hao. Oh, Kevin.
Yes. Hello, everyone. I'm Kevin. I also work in PingCap company and team leader of the community and the business development. And I also community manager of ChatKV. I'm very glad to be here. So if you have anything about ChatKV community, feel free to ask your questions. That's all. Thank you.
Okay, thank you, Kevin. Welcome.
Hello everyone. My name is Chang Bokang. You can call me Bokang or Connor. I'm a software engineer from PingCap ChatKV team, and now I'm mainly working on Titan engine, a key value separate engine built on RocksDB. Today I'm going to give you some updates about NGI SIG. So glad to meet you all. Thank you.
Thank you, Bokang. Zhao Lei.
Hello everyone, I'm Zhao Lei. I'm the committer of Transaction SRG. That's all.
Thank you. Tang Liu.
Hi, hello everyone. My name is Liu Tang. I'm the author of TechKV. Sadly, I have not been contributed to TechKV for a long time now, but I still nearly review the PR and the issue every day. Thank you very much.
Thanks. And Tang Liu is also one of the maintainer of TechKV project. Sherry.
Hi, I'm Sherry. I'm a committer for transaction SIG and the coprocessor SIG. And now I'm working on TechKV's developer ecosystem. So if you have any related questions, you can ask me. That's all. Sorry, I can't hear you. Seems I can't see the screen and I can't hear you.
Hello, can you hear us?
Yes.
Okay, it works. Sorry about the problem. Let's continue this meeting.
So I think I have finished my introduction to myself.
Introduction by yourself. Okay, so I will okay.
Okay, what about now?
I think it's okay. So we can start from Si Tu Ma.
Okay.
Hey people, my name is C2. So I'm from LA, just working a small company, and recently got interested with TiDB. So just take me as an observer. Thank you.
Welcome.
Welcome. Thanks, C2. Next is Yao Wei.
Hi, can you hear me?
Yes.
I'm Yao Wei, I'm from PingCap. And I also am a maintainer of TechKV. I mainly focus on community of TechKV and DB. I'm also a leader.
Hello?
Hello?
Seems Yao is offline.
Okay. Now, next is Wen Xuan.
Hello, I'm Wen Xuan or Wish from PingCap. I'm the tech lead of Co-processor SIG, and now I'm mainly working on the co-processor model and also the TiDB dashboard project. That's all, thank you.
Thank you. And Xiaoguang.
Hello everyone, I'm Xiao Guang. I'm a TechWee maintainer. I work for Zhihu. Right now we are building a table store on top of TechWee and we're going to open source it. I hope thank you.
So everyone, can you hear me? Can you hear me? Okay, so there is a participant from the TechEV community. Can you introduce yourself? Which one is the from the TechEV community? Okay, so what's the next part?
I think the next one is Zhou Zhenjing and Zhong Zhenshi.
So what's the next part? Okay, can you introduce your work in TechEV? Zhenjing, are you here?
Can you hear me?
Yes.
Oh, Zhenjing, can you hear me?
So I am Zhou Zhenjing. I'm from PingCap, and I am I'm working in TechEV team, and I am a member of Transaction SIE, and I should be the tech leader of Transaction SG, but recently I'm busy in other work, so now Shuaipeng is help me doing the work of the SIG's tech leader.
Okay, so who's the next?
I think it's Zhong Zhenshi. And he will also give us a demo in this meeting later.
I think there's some.
Hello.
Hello.
Hello? Hello? Can you hear me?
I can always hear you, but it's very noisy.
I think there's something wrong with your audio. It's too noisy. A lot of background noise. Can you please check that?
Is Queenie there?
Queenie is not here.
Okay, but we are here to congratulations and congrats to Queenie to be the CNCF Ambassador Spotlight. Is there a web page to show her? Because I remember there is a web page to show her photos and introduction. Maybe we can show it on the meeting. Her introduction is on the CNCF website, right?
Yes.
So we are here to thank you for the Queenie's contribution to Thai Kiwi community and to the CNCF.
Shirley, can you hear us? Can we move on to the news part?
Yeah.
Yeah, I can hear you.
Okay, can we move on to the news part?
Let me share the screen.
Yes, here we go.
Okay. So first, Queenie Jin has been on the CNCF Ambassador Spotlight, and she has been spreading the word about Thai Kiwi to English speakers since 2016. Congratulations to her, and thanks for her contributions to Thai Kiwi. And second, Thai Kiwi speaking sessions on KiwiCon EU have been scheduled on August 19 and August 20. There are two sessions. First one is Thai Kiwi, a cloud native Kiwi database, is presented by Ed and Nick. Second session is serving children record table on Thai Kiwi. It's presented by Yi Wu and Xiaohuang. So if you are interested in our speaking sessions on KeepCon, mark your calendars and join us. And third, the TaiKiwi logo was updated with Thai added before Kiwi. As you can see, the updated version is on the right side. CNCF has confirmed this update, and we are updating this logo on West Side and GitHub. And that's all for the easy for the news. And let's move on to the SIP updates. I would like in this part, SIP leader will present the SIP updates to you. If you have any questions, please click the raise hand button to let me know, and I will call you to speak. So the first is co-processor SIP. Wenxuan.
Okay. In this month, there are mainly two projects in the co-processor SIP. The one is timeline tracing, and the other is trunk-based computing. For the timeline tracing, there will be a demo later in this meeting, so you can see it. And I will not introduce too much here. For the trunk-based computing, it is elected as a community bridge project, and the student is Zhang Chi from Shanghai Jiao Tong University. I and our committer, Tianli Zhuang, will be mentors. That's all, thank you.
Thanks, Vish. And next is NGC, Bokang.
Okay, thanks, Jay. For NGSIG, the most important work recently is Google Summer of Code. There are two projects that are accepted by the program. One is Cloud Native Kiwi Service, and the other is Version Low Kiwi. I'm not sure about if anyone knows about the background on that, so let me give some brief introduction. The Cloud Native Kiwi Service is to adapt TaiKiwi on cloud to leverage the durability of cloud storage such as EBS or S3. And the version raw KiWi, usually called version KiWi, is a middle thing between raw KiWi and transaction KiWi. In short, it's just like raw KiWi with MECC support, but without transaction. Both of them are already applied by students. You can see on the PPT. And the design documents are attached to the PPT by link. You can check it later for more details. And apart from these, there are some other works related to NG. First, a contributor from Vivo has sent a PR to make Titan support the compaction filter. And making Titan support the user merge operator and the raw KiWi manual compaction triggered by deletes are still under discussion. That's all for the monthly update of NGSD, but there are still many issues are not selected by anyone, so are not listed on the PPT. You can check them in the NGSD project of TaiKiwi GitHub repo. If anyone are interested in them, please feel free to leave any comments and join NGSIG Slack channel to work with us. Thank you.
Thank you, welcome. And next is performance SIP. Liu Wei.
I'm Liu Wei from performance SIG. And the middle of performance SIG. This is we are focused on the performance improvement of TDB and TaiKiwi. We have found the ability to merge multiple requests together to reduce the time that the thread context switches. There is one PR that we we committed last week, or no, last week, maybe a month ago. And tried to create one RocksDB's snapshot for multiple data requests, even if they are from different regions. I get the timestamp at first and then check the timestamp at each Ruffle instance. If this timestamp is still in need of legal, and then you will use the RocksDB snapshot created before to deal with its Ruffle request. This here will reduce the RocksDB snapshot gate times. We hope you can do the similar things for other requests such as proposition.
So how does it perform?
We have improved the copies of Git request for or by 6%.
Cool. Thanks, Liu Wei. And next is Ruff C. And I will introduce the update. So this month we have developed a new feature named commit group. In the naive commit algorithm about Ruff is simple majority. And we add some constraints to how to commit logs. We divide the peers in a Ruff group into several subgroups. Only logs that are replicated to at least two groups are considered committed. And it's a way to delay commit, as the description says, it's a way to delay committing and make sure data safety. We use these features to implement our synchronous replication in double data center. Without these features, when you want to ensure data integrity, you will have to use like even number of backups. And after using these features, we can ensure only logs replicated to at least two labels, AKA two data centers, and they will be committed. The other one is priority election. It's a feature implemented by a community contributor. It adds a priority to each peer, and during elections, all rules doesn't change. Only logs are more up to date can become leader, but the priority taking effect in when they are logs are actually equal, and the low priority peer will not vote for the higher priority peer will not vote for the low priority peer. The feature is to make sure in some critical deployment environment that not all machines are the same, or not all network are the same. We can set those machines with lower configurations to a lower priority, so they are unlikely to become a leader. And that's all for the Ruff seek. Next is transaction seek. I think it's Charlie.
Yes, because Xiaopeng is busy. I will introduce the progress of transaction. This month, we focused on the stability. And we did some works on the stability of large transactions, which can avoid story speed issue under heavy write flow. As you can see, the first PR is before writing to TidyB will pre-split regions when there are lots of data because the performance of a single wrapped group is not very good. And the next PR is TidyB will collapse some duplicated requests so that TidyB needn't process duplicated requests. And this month, there are 9 new members joined us, and we will pay more attention to community. For example, we have posted our weekly report in transactions SRG, and we will write a serious docs about implementation of transactions in TidyB, so that anyone who is interested in it can join us easily. That's all.
Thanks, Charlie. Very impressive progress in community.
Yeah.
And is there anyone have questions about the SIG updates? Okay, now let's welcome Zheng Chi to give a demo on MiniChase. But I think Zheng Chi's microphone is quite noisy. Do you fix that? If not, I think can we give a presentation instead?
Is it working?
I think your microphone is still broken.
I think if we cannot fix this, we might give this presentation to our next community meeting because we cannot really hear anything.
How about now?
Yes, it's a lot better, but it's a little, your voice is a little low. Can you make it louder?
Okay. Is it well now?
It's very good now.
Oh, okay, okay. Well, I'm going to share my screen.
Now you can share your screen. Okay, now we can see you.
Hello, everyone. I'm Tong Zhengshi, an intern of PingCap and joined PingCap for almost 4 months. During this month's internship, I studied the tracing system and implemented a tracing library called MiniChase, which is also the subject of this demo. Okay, let's get started. Those who are familiar with TidyB may know that currently we have matches, log, and queries to diagnose TidyB cluster. These tools are all helpful to find the problem. However, they are either only observing the overall situation of the TidyB cluster, such as matches, or multiple components are difficult to associate together according to a SQL, such as log. MiniChase is used to solve these problems. It can trace the cross time from multiple components in a single request. Also, the performance of MiniChase is pretty good. there is almost no performance loss after introduction. At the same time, using MiniChess does not require any modification to the existing function signature. You can use Yager UI to visualize the results of MiniChess. So we can get the timelines of every TiKV request. All events have a name from top to bottom. We can get the relationship between events. From left to right, we can know the sequence of events. Click on the span, there is specific information, such as start time, duration. It seems that chasing is really useful, but why MiniChess? What are the advantages of MiniChess? In Rust community, we can easily find some chasing libraries, such as Tokyo Chasing and Rust Chasing. In particular, Tokyo Chasing maintained by the Tokyo project is a good ecology. So why should we make a new wheel? The reason is straightforward for performance. As demonstrated by the micro benchmark here, MiniChess only takes 20 nanoseconds to generate a span, which is 17.5 times faster than Rust Chasing and 100 times faster than Tokyo Chasing. Cool, right? Someone may ask, do we really need such a high performance chasing library? Let's look at the integration benchmark. Here, 100 events are chased during TiKV point get. That is, 100 spans are connected. It can be seen that when it is not chased, we got 183k QPS. With MiniChess, we got 173k. But with Rust Chasing, it was directly reduced to 90k. We do need a high performance chasing library. It's usually unacceptable to half QPS after introducing the chasing facility. However, don't worry about the 6% performance regression with MiniChess. In real life, we will only chase less than 10 events for point get, and the performance impact will be hardly observable. I believe you are all concerned, why is this so fast? We were inspired by NanoLog to maintain per-thread buffers to reduce synchronization between threads. Thanks to this design, we can also use batch connection to reduce the number of copies. We also use GSC to record the time, which is faster than attaining the system time from OS. In addition, we avoid using strings to name events, but numbers instead. We optimize the size of structures to better fit cache, and so on. The current performance is not the end. We will still have the opportunity to further optimize it in the future. After talking about the performance advantages of MiniChess, let's take a look at the situation of MiniChess in the open source community. MiniChess is compatible with existing chasing protocols. As shown previously, we can easily integrate MiniChess into chasing systems such as OpenChasing and Yager. We also have contributions from community. I'd like to appreciate Ren Kai and Rich Rich for their contributions. To summarize, MiniChess is a high performance, general purpose, and young chasing library, which is still improving. Here's the report link, and all comments from you are welcome. That's all.
Thanks, Zheng Qi. Minitrace is very impressive. I believe it can tell us a lot in analyzing the whole system. And thanks, Zheng Qi and Yuan Kai and Wish. The last part comes to our community time. We want to hear some feedback from the community. Anyone has some feedback for us? Or do you have any questions about the C updates or the mini chase demo? So if you have anything to tell us, you can also contact us. Okay. If you have anything to tell us, you could contact us on Slack channel. And we come to the end of our meeting. And I would like to say thanks again to presenters today for their informative talks and all the attendees for their participation. Thank you for joining us at this meeting today. Can I ask all of you a favor to help us complete the survey to be sent? It helps us with future planning because your feedback is crucial for us to make our community meeting better. And don't forget to click the leave meeting button later. Otherwise, the recording video will be 2 hours long. And thank you all. I will see you in June.
Thanks. Bye.
Thank you.